Bus has recorded a staggering 1,742 cases of COVID-19, the highest daily total since the pandemic began. It comes as the state's hospitals have been placed on red alert, and COVID testing clinics, as we've been seeing on the news, have seen a huge rush. For more, we're joined by infectious diseases expert Professor Mary Louise McClaws in Sydney. Professor, great to see you again. Just a week to go till Christmas, a little bit over now. Should we be concerned about this?
Oh, I think we should be. I mean, we've had an eightfold increase in yesterday's case number compared to the average case numbers over November, and they were in about the 200. And now all of a sudden, we've got the highest number we've had in New South Wales. And I think that this is sadly heralding a fourth wave. We really do need to be looking after ourselves, having our booster shots as soon as possible, wearing masks, and thinking about maybe using rapid antigen testing before you go somewhere socially and when you get back from a big social occasion.
Professor, we just had Peter Dutton on then, and he's taken the government line and many premiers' lines as well, is that this is what we need to do now. We need to live with COVID. We need to bite the bullet here. We need to stare into it and sort of just go through this. We're all at, like, over 90% vaccinated in this country. Isn't this something that we just have to deal with now?
Gosh, it's a really tough have-to-deal-with-now situation. I mean, just recently, New South Wales Health put out a weekly report that showed that 26% of all cases were the 0 to 9 years of age. So the 0 to 19 years of age represented nearly half of all cases, and we can't vaccinate them yet until January. So we really do have to be careful, because what we've learned from the England experience when Delta happened, all of a sudden children became the target for the virus, and this is exactly what's happening again with Delta and potentially with Omicron. So while adults may be vaccinated and feeling quite comfortable with living with this, the children yet have not been vaccinated, and they are at great risk of being the next big group.
Well, we're seeing restrictions roll back in New South Wales. No QR codes for checking in, no need to show your vaccination cards, desperate, no need for masks in most places, whereas Queensland's going back to mask mandates. What's the better tactic here?
Well, you know, as a member of a WHO infection prevention and control group for COVID, of course I agree with the WHO approach, and that is this vaccine is great, but it's not the only infection control measure. Why? Because the virus keeps changing. So we do have to have other measures that include things like mask use and testing, rapid antigen testing. The UK roll out to their constituents free rapid antigen tests. Singapore does, and now New Zealand. And it really is a very important public health measure that should be 100% supported by the government to make them free, so that you can have at least one a day. And before you go out, you can test yourself to ensure that you're not inadvertently taking infection with you, because even though you are protected against severe infection and death, you may not be protected from a very mild or silent infection and spread it to others who may become very, very sick and have to be hospitalised.
All right, Professor Mary Louise McClaws, we'll leave it there, but thank you so much for your insight this morning.